Okay, class 11. Now, today we are going to learn about the indirect method for measuring large distance. So, indirect method, in indirect method, this method is very important method, parallax method. So, in parallax method, first we must know about parallax. So, parallax is the apparent shift in the position of an eye with respect to another when we shift our eye sidewise. So the closer always appears to move in the direction opposite to that of our eye. So to understand the parallax, we'll consider this situation. To understand parallax, hold a pen at O. So this point, this is the position of the pen at a distance S from the eyes. This S from the eyes, this is the position of eyes. These are the position of eyes. Look at the pen first by left eye. Look at the pen first by left eye by closing right eye. And then by right eye by closing this left eye. The position of the pen appears to change with respect to the background. With respect to background, background means in front of the tent there is a wall, there is a tree, there is a road, there is a building. So that is background. So this is called parallax. So this phenomenon is called parallax. So the distance between the two points of observation is called base. So point of observation is called base. This is base. Now this is left eye and this is right eye. So, left eye and right eye makes an angle. This is left eye, right eye. This is observation, no, position of the pen. And left eye and right eye makes the angle with the object is theta. So, this angle is known as parallactic angle. This angle is parallactic angle, P-A-R-A-L-L-E, parallactic angle, L-L-A-C-T-I-C, parallactic angle. Okay. Now, we will be talking about distance of near by stars by parallax method. Okay, distance of nearby stars by parallax method. So in parallax method, suppose N is the nearby star. So N, this is N, not O. Now this is N. N is the nearby star whose distance d from the earth. So this distance is d. From here also d is to be found. F is the far of stars. So these two points is the position of far of stars. F is the position of far of stars whose distance and position is fixed for all position of the earth. So this distance is, this distance and position is fixed for all position of the earth. Means now this is the path of earth which revolve around the sun. This is the position of the sun. So this is the path of earth, revolutionary path of earth. So F is, this position is fixed, position and distance is fixed of the earth in its orbital motion. So when the earth is at position A, When the earth is at position A, the parallax angle between distant star F and nearby star N will be theta 1. So parallax angle, when the position of earth is at A, the parallax angle between the nearby object and far off object or nearby star and far off star will be theta 1 is determined. Let it be theta 1. This is theta 1. So after 6 months the position of the earth is at B. After 6 months the position the earth is at diametrically opposite direction B. Diametrically, before 6 months the position of the earth is at A. Now after 6 months the position of the earth is at B. So the parallax angle theta 2 is measured. Parallax angle between the far off stars and the nearest stars will be theta 2. Now first we will calculate the parallactic angle. So parallactic angle is angle made by the two position at nearby stars. So now calculate first parallactic angle. Parallactic angle is, so this is theta 1. Now this line is parallel to this line and this is parallel to this, means theta 1, this is theta 1 and this is also theta 1 because alternate interior angle. Now this is theta 2 and this is also theta 2 because of alternate interior angle. Now first we will calculate the total angle at N. Now parallactic angle theta. Parallactic angle theta equals to, this is theta. So theta equals to theta 1 plus theta 2. Now we will calculate what is theta in terms of radian. It is length of arc divided by the radius L by R. So theta equals to arc length by radius. So theta equals to arc length is AB is the arc length. AB is the arc length. So this is AB by radius is D. So AB by D. Now AB is considered as B. This is considered as B. So theta equals to B by D. Now if B is known and distance is known, we can calculate the parallactic angle. If theta is known, B is known, then we can calculate the distance of nearby star. So this is the formula of calculation of theta, position and the distance of nearby stars. So if you calculate distance, D equals to B by theta. If you want to calculate B, so position means this distance B, so this equals to theta into D. Now we have to learn this formula for calculation for distance of nearby stars. from the odd. Now, before going to the calculation part, we must know some thing about the theta. Okay, angle theta. We know that the complete revolution or complete rotation is 360 degree. So 360 degree in terms of radian, it is called 2π radian. 2π radian. So we can write here 360 degree is 2π radian. Now first this equation divided by 2, it is 180 degree. Is pi radian. So 180 degree equals to pi radian. So pi radian 90 degree means, now this is divided by 2, so pi by 2 radian. Radian, it is radian, R A D I A N. Radian is represented by R A. Now 60 degree means it is divided by 3. Equals to pi by 3 radian. Now 45 degree pi by 4 radian, because now this equation is divided by 4 in both sides. Now 30 degree is pi by 6 radian. This equation is divided by 6. If you divide 180 by 180, if you divide this equation by 180, 1 degree equals to pi by 180 radian. Now this is the formula for 1 degree. Similarly, we have to calculate 1 radian. So we know that 2 pi equals to 360 degree, 2 pi radian. Pi radian is 180 degree. Pi by 2 radian is 90 degree. Then pi by 3 radian is 60 degree. Pi by 4 radian equals to 45 degree. And last one is pi by 6 radian is 30 degree. If you divide this equation by pi, you will get 1 radian. 1 radian equals to 180 by pi degree. Now this is the formula for 1 radian. So 1 radian equals to 180 by pi. So 2 radian will be 2 into 180 by pi. 10 radian equals to 10 into 180 by pi. Similarly, here 1 degree is 2 pi by 180 radian. For 2 degree equals to 2 into 180 by pi by 180 radian. Similarly, if you have 45 degree here, so 45 degree equals to 45 into pi by 180 radian, you will get pi by 4 radian. So 45 radian is 45 degree. 45 degree equals to 45 degree into 1 by 180 radian. So 45 4. So 45 degree is equals to pi by 4 radian. Similarly, we can calculate 30 degree in terms of radian. So 30 degree is 30 into pi by 180 radian. So 30 into 6 is 180. So we will get pi by 6 radian. Okay, now this was for today. Next class, I'll solve some numerical problems based on parallactic angle and the relation between the degree and the radian. So, thank you.